to get back after it, I reckon. I'll come back down here to Florida. Figured I'd get into some ruddy deer one more time and kill me one more and hang it up. I eat all that meat too fast. Let's head back down here. Check some cameras. It looks like I'm in good shape, so we'll hang out in here for the morning. And Lord willing, he'll send me one. And hopefully I get good enough footage to show it to you. I got in here in my little stick that I was hanging my GoPro on. A squirrel or something done broke it off, so I haven't anchored right here to this backpack, and it ain't very sturdy, and it's 3 foot above my head, so I don't know if I'm gonna have time to reach up there and turn it on or not. I know I'll have time to turn this one on, but as always, it probably ain't gonna be that good of footage, but like I said before, this ain't National Geographic. We're gonna hang in here and see what I can do. I'll click you back on. See nothing after them little yearlings fed through. So I just went ahead and got down, went in town and ate, and here I am back. And a lot of traffic through here though. Not one good buck on camera, but ones do right here. I mean, these scrapes are torn to pieces, and there's a big old group of does right here, and I know they're starting to get right, so eventually a good buck will pick up in here, but I'm willing to shoot a 4-point at this point. There's a pretty decent big-bodied 4-point coming in here, and I'll shoot him for some meat, you know. But I'll hang in here, see what I can do. I'll click you back on as soon as something starts moving. All right, I'm gonna bail out of here. Go to this other spot. This wind is killing me. It's done got wrong again. Right in that bedding area. And this other spot I'm going to, it ain't good for nothing but of a morning set, really. Unless you just, you know, want to slide in somewhere for the last hour because you get cooked in the sun of the evening. So I'm just going to ease down. Save this for in the morning. This other deer, I got a freaking 12 point over here that's a sure enough good buck. And maybe he'll slide in here this evening on these does. They've been a bunch of does feeding over here. So I'll click you back on when we get in that tree. Alright, I made it in here. I'm gonna start putting on some more clothes. I know as soon as that sun goes below them trees, it's gonna get cold. Got in here, that wind was kind of cutting towards this bedding area. I was like, dang, I should have just stayed where I'm at, but it's straightening out now and doing better. I just feel better about this for some reason. I just didn't want to sit there and blow that out and run that deer over to somebody else, because I know an old boy hunts on the back end of that. I'm going to get finished getting ready. I'll click you back on, and hopefully this big buck will show up this evening. He's a fine and born. If I kill him, man, I'm done for the year. But I'll click you back on here in a little bit. Disturbing anything. I think I'll be back right here in the morning. That goat's about to drive me insane. That old boy come out there and went to cussing that goat, telling him he's gonna kill him and shit. That goat, he's quiet for a minute, and as soon as that old boy shut the door, that goat went to going on again. I'll click you back on tomorrow.
Alright, follow in morning. I'm trying to slide back up here and make a play on him. I laying there in the bed last night thinking, you know, I probably don't need to go up here to that hilltop stand. I probably need to go back over there where I was yesterday morning and get right back in there on them deer, because historically here lately, a morning like today with a real good calm wind, just clear and cold, that place has been producing some daylight pigs. So I'd probably be a fool to go to that other spot where there's just a lot of traffic going through there and very slim amount of daylight pigs coming in over there. So just gonna go over here and try to kill this decent 7 point, and there's a decent 8 point there too, but would really like to have that 7 point. And then I'll work my way back over to that other spot maybe tomorrow or this evening, but I just feel like my chances would be better where I'm going. And that's the name of the game. I mean, you got to put yourself in a position to have the best chance of getting a daylight encounter here. These deer down here are so nocturnal that it's almost virtually impossible to do it with a, you know, a 3.5 to 4.5 or older buck. He's just not gonna stagger around out there in the daylight for you. But I'm gonna ease up here and get in this tree. I'll click you back on whenever I get a chance.
I made it in here somehow. I ain't spooked nothing. At least I didn't hear nothing spook. was getting my bow out of the truck and leaned over and hit the dadgum horn. That was the only fudge up. But hopefully that didn't hurt nothing. Maybe I run them down in here. I'm parked so far away that where the truck is, maybe it pushed them down into this block. I don't know. But watch his son come up, drink his coffee. Hopefully we get one in here and I can put a stick in him. little scrubby looking 3-point, but if my big buck was in here, them little bucks probably wouldn't be in here. It's a real small bedding area and they come out of it. They wouldn't be in there. If he was in there, he'd run them out. But hey, got some meat for summer. That was really all I was looking to do. Start focusing on some bighorns for the duration. I ain't gonna have too much longer down here, but have me a little bit of time to maybe put some more ivory on the ground. I'm gonna hang in here and enjoy the morning. Cover that deer here in a little bit. I was debating on shooting him, but I got to thinking about it, you know, it's been so hard to get any kind of daylight movement out of any deer, even a doe. Probably better take this opportunity to get some meat. Thank you, Jesus. I don't think you can kill 2 deer in 1 day in Florida anymore. My phone died, so I can't look it up. Still got these little fellers down here. So I think I'm on bail. I don't want a good buck to come in here and me have to break the law. Get these little fellas out here. Where y'all go? Get. Go. You better go. Those were all 3 little button bucks. I don't care that. I probably need to educate them like that around here. They won't live long unless they get some education, so maybe they'll grow up to be big bucks now. Walk around looking up the rest of their lives. All right, let me get out. Of course, I chose the wrong stand this morning. Went and checked another spot and put out some corn. Check the camera there, and freaking nice 8-point daylighted there. And I had a gut feeling this morning I probably should have went there, but hey, it is what it is. It's part of it. Got too many good spots. Not a bad problem to have, you know. I'm gonna ease in there and drop a little corn. Go retrieve this scrub and go jerk the hide off of him and get ready for this evening. I guess I'm gonna run over there where I was just at and climb in there last thing and see if that buck will come back in there with them does he was with this morning. Hopefully get to throw a stick at him. Hopefully find this deer right here. I'm getting ahead of myself. Making this seem way too easy. But
Look at these scrapes right here. They're in here, ain't they? Let me find my arrow and everything here. Oh, here it is. Yeah. He ain't go too far. But let me get this corn out and go find that deer. Good blood right here. Right here where I'm standing. My daddy went far. I put it where it's supposed to be. I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm thankful he's got that fork right there. I was kind of second guessing myself, thinking he might be a spike, but he's a four pointer almost. But hey man, that's perfect for meat.
Well, it's February the 3rd. And I got up late this morning and just figured I'd make me some coffee and sit right here at the window and eat me some breakfast and watch this corn pile in the backyard. Got two or three decent bucks here. Got one real giant buck here, but old boy Streetwise, man, he's been here a little while and he knows the drill. This time of year, he don't daylight, but early season, he's pretty regular in the daylight here, but I'm usually in Virginia or North Carolina then, you know, and by the time I get back, he's on that night routine. So doubtful I'll see him, but one of these decent bucks eases through here, I might pop him for some snack sticks or something like that for this summer. Got that buck the other day and I'm thankful for that, but I need just one more and then I'll be satisfied. So I'm gonna just sit right here and enjoy some coffee, cook me some breakfast. I'll click you back on if anything eases in here.
Got him that time.
ain't quite the quality I was looking for, but I'll take it. Getting to hang out there in the heat and drink coffee and kill one, I'll take that any day. Need some snack sticks for summer. About to say, surely there ain't another one in there. But been trying to kill this big 10 point here at the house for a month now, and just it ain't produced. So I figured I might as well take the opportunity and get this deer, get me a little more meat. Let me get over here to him, I'll show him to you. He ain't very big. Little scrubby 6 point or something, but I'll click you back on here a second. Let me get over. Well, there he is. I hit him the first go around. Old boy Ruddy and juiced up. Say I hit him. He had run down, boy. Oh yeah. I definitely hit him the first go around. Alright. Get him on his cart. I mean, you can't beat that. And they're drinking coffee. And was able to get it done.